गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप एंड प्रे टू गॉड दैट यू आर फाइन, राइट? ओके, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन अबाउट इनफ्लेमेबल सब्सटेंस, टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन, राइट? रैपिड कंबशन, देन स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन एंड एक्सप्लोशन. नाउ फ्लेम, I told you to read it once. Okay. Observe the flames of different objects and you will see that there is a change of color. Here you can see the color of candle flame and the flame of kitchen stove. Right? One is yellow orange, one is blue. Again 6.9 you can see flame of kerosene lamp, then candle and the Bunsen burner. What difference will you see? Their color will be different, right? Why is it so? That we will study now. The structure of a flame. Light a candle. Now hold it for 4-5 centimeter long thin glass tube with a pair of tongs and introduce its one end in the dark zone of the candle as shown in the figure. What you have to do? एक कैंडल है, उसके ऊपर ग्लास ट्यूब है, उसको गर्म किया है. एंड देन वॉट यू विल डू? यू हैव टू होल्ड फॉर 5 सेंटीमीटर लॉन्ग थिन ग्लास ट्यूब विद अ पेयर ऑफ टोंग्स एंड इंट्रोड्यूस इट वन एंड इन द डार्क जोन ऑफ कैंडल फ्लेम. एकदम अंदर जो डार्क जोन होता है वहां पे. Bring a lighted matchstick near the other end of the glass tube. Do you see a flame caught at this end? If so, what is it that produces a flame? We will see it. The substance which vaporizes during burning give flames. For example, kerosene, oil, wax. They rise through the wick and are vaporized during burning and form flame. ऐसे सब्सटेंस है जो बर्न करने पे वेपराइज हो जाते हैं, उनमें फ्लेम्स होती है. क्या होती है? फ्लेम्स होती है. वाइल चारकोल ऑन द अदर हैंड डज नॉट वेपराइज एंड सो डज नॉट प्रोड्यूस अ फ्लेम. है ना? चारकोल, उसमें फ्लेम नहीं होती है क्योंकि वो वेपराइज नहीं होता है. इन 6.5 एक्टिविटी कुड द वेपर्स ऑफ वैक्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ द ग्लास ट्यूब बी द कॉज ऑफ फ्लेम प्रोड्यूस्ड? वैक्स है, वो वेपर हो जाता है तो वो ग्लास ट्यूब में से जाएगा. सो ऑन द अदर एंड व्हेन यू विल लाइट अ मैच स्टिक मीन दैट वेपराइज्ड वैक्स which is collected in the test tube will burn, right? Okay, when the candle flame is steady, introduce a glass plate side और उसको थोड़ी देर ऊपर पकड़ के रखो. उधर एक ब्लैक सब्सटेंस जमा हो जाता है ना. A circular blackish ring is formed. It indicates the deposition of unburned carbon particles. They are unburned carbon particles. Means there is not a complete combustion. थोड़ा कुछ रह जाता है बर्न होने में और जो बर्न नहीं होता है वो कार्बन पार्टिकल्स उधर एक्यूमुलेट हो जाते हैं. राइट? नाउ होल्ड अ थिन लॉन्ग कॉपर वायर जस्ट इनसाइड द नॉन ल्यूमिनस जोन ऑफ फ्लेम. Notice that the portion of the copper wire just outside the flame gets red hot. Does it indicate that the non-flammable zone of the flame has a high temperature? In fact, this part of the flame is the hottest part. I will show you the different zones of the candle. Here you can see the picture. There are three zones: the outer zone, the middle zone, and the innermost zone. There are three different colors if you observe the flame very properly. एकदम अच्छे से अगर फ्लेम को आप ऑब्जर्व करेंगे, यू कैन सी थ्री कलर्स, तीन लेयर जैसे दिखेंगे. द फर्स्ट आउटर मोस्ट जोन, आउटर मोस्ट जोन देर इज अ कंप्लीट कंबशन एंड इट इज ऑफ ब्लू कलर. व्हेन देर इज अ कंप्लीट कंबशन इट इज ऑफ ब्लू कलर, आउटर मोस्ट जोन इट इज द हॉटेस्ट पार्ट. Then the middle zone, there is a partial combustion, it is of yellow color. It is moderately hot. Then the innermost zone, that is the unburnt part, it is a black color. Right? It is the least hot. These are the zones of a flame, candle flame. The outermost zone, it is of blue color, there is a complete combustion. And it is the hottest part. Middle zone, yellow color, it is a partial combustion, moderately hot. Innermost zone, there is in unburnt wax, there is no combustion, and it is the least hot. Right? So these are the stages of flame, structure of flame. With different zone, the long answer can be asked. Explain the structure of flame with the diagram. You have to draw this diagram, right? Mention it properly, the layers, the types of combustion, the heat, everything, and explain it step by step. Okay. Goldsmiths blow the outermost zone of a flame with a metallic blowpipe for melting gold and silver. ऊपर की जो फ्लेम है उसी को वो लोग यूज करते हैं बिकॉज दे नीड अ वेरी हॉट थिंग. Why do they use the outermost zone? Because to melt these things, metals, you need a very high temperature. So the outermost zone is the hottest one. So they are using that part. What is the fuel? What is fuel? Recall that the sources of heat energy for domestic and industrial purpose are mainly wood, petrol, charcoal, etc. These substances are called fuel. The good fuel is one which is readily available, is cheap, will burn easily at a moderate rate, and produce a large amount of heat. Also, it does not leave behind any undesirable substances. That is called an ideal fuel. There is probably no fuel that could be considered as an ideal fuel. है ना, कोई भी फ्यूल में सारी क्वालिटीज जो अभी हमने बोली वो नहीं होती है. अगर इजीली अवेलेबल है तो ज़्यादा कॉस्टली भी होगा. अगर चीप है तो वो कुछ अनबर्न पार्टिकल पीछे छोड़ देगा. सो प्रोबेबली आइडियल फ्यूल में जो जिसमें ये सारी क्वालिटी वैसा नहीं होता है, बट विच हैव द मैक्सिमम क्वालिटीज यू कैन टेल देम आइडियल फ्यूल. वी शुड लुक फॉर अ फ्यूल विच फुलफिल मोस्ट ऑफ अवर रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर अ पर्टिक्यूलर यूज. फ्यूल्स डिफर इन देयर कॉस्ट, सम आर चीपर, सम आर नॉट. Also, the fuels are in different state of matters, such as solid, liquid, or gases. Now, fuel efficiency. How will you determine the efficiency of fuel? The amount of heat produced on complete combustion of 1 kg of fuel is called its calorific. The amount of heat produced on complete combustion of 1 kg of fuel is called its calorific value. The calorific value of a fuel is expressed in a unit called kilojoule per kg, that is K and capital J per kg. Calorific values of some fuels are given in a table. You can see cow dung, cake, wood, coal, सबकी अलग अलग है. कितना हीट वो प्रोड्यूस करते हैं कंप्लीट कंबशन में 1 kg में, दैट इज कॉल्ड इट्स कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. सबसे ज़्यादा किसकी है? बायोगैस. बायोगैस सबसे ज़्यादा किसकी? यस इट इज हाइड्रोजन. और सबसे कम काउ डंग केक, राइट. पेट्रोल केरोसिन डीजल सब एक जैसे ही. सो दिस इज, ये याद रखना, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस टेबल. इट कैन कम इन वन सेंटेंस ब्लैंक, चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन एनीवेयर. Burning of fuel leads to harmful products. The increasing fuel consumption has harmful effects on the environment. Carbon fuels like wood, coal, petroleum release unburned carbon particles. These fine particles are dangerous pollutants, causing respiratory diseases such as asthma. Carbon particles जो unburned रह जाते हैं air में mix हो जाते हैं and they are causing the respiratory diseases such as asthma. Incomplete combustion of this fuel gives carbon monoxide gas. कौन सा gas देता है? Carbon monoxide. This can even kill a person. It is a very poisonous gas. And when this gas is mixed in the air, it is again dangerous. Third point, it is combustion of most fuel will release carbon dioxide in the environment. And this is causing global warming. Increased amount of carbon dioxide in the air is believed to be the cause of global warming. Burning of coal and diesel release sulfur dioxide gas. It is extremely suffocating and corrosive gas. उसमें सांस नहीं ले सकते. It is very suffocating. Moreover, petrol engine gives off gaseous oxides of nitrogen. एक sulfur dioxide, एक nitrogen oxide. When these oxides of sulfur and nitrogen dissolve in the rain water, they will form acids, and that rain is called acid rain, right? When sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides released from the vehicles mixed in the rain, they will form acids, and this rain is called acid rain. It is very harmful for crops, buildings and soil, right? The use of diesel and petrol as fuels in automobiles is now being replaced with CNG, that is compressed natural gas, which will release less amount of carbon dioxide. It is comparatively cleaner fuel, right? Okay, the exercise we will do it in the next video. Okay, thank you.